basis, and rental over that long term period is something that will be really important to us and worth to the city. Planning consideration, strong design, I've already said quite a lot of that, and there is obviously this emergence of the green agenda, particularly at national level, and we want to keep a close eye on that as a company moving forward. I think the availability of funding is really important as well. We are a company, you know, we're not a social housing provider, we don't have the same ability to access funds from organisations like Homes England that a registered provider would. So a lot of our funding at the moment is based on loans from the council at a commercial rate. In due course, we hope that through our conversations and negotiation with the council, that we may be able to look elsewhere for our funding, particularly in the case of some of the modular build providers possibly, and that is something that will be an important action point for us moving forward. And just moving on to the point about access to funding for problematic sites, I think it's already been discussed within the meeting tonight, the issue of renewal, dealing with things maybe akin to the way in which things were dealt with under housing market renewal. There's a massive policy agenda at national level that actually required to enable that policy change, but also, who knows, even maybe some funding changes in due course, so that all of the money that's coming through government isn't solely directed at new build and acquisition of new build. Okay, so just to conclude the presentation from foundations, obviously we're working very closely with the City Council as our shareholder. We do want to deliver mixed communities where there is a mix of foundations, properties, homes to buy, homes to rent, and also council houses as well. One of the schemes that has got planning permission over the last period, that is a foundations project from birth in effect, is a scheme that we're working very closely on with council offices in the new tree ward. And that will be a scheme that will deliver just over 100 properties in that particular part of the city and in that particular way. I've already said a lot about being a flag bearer for sustainable design, good quality design moving forward, and that will be one of our key mantras. And we will look at the national policy agenda and work closely with both local government, regional and national government to make sure that we can deliver sustainable design moving forward. I think the final comment that I want to make is that we are an ambitious company. You know, I've only touched upon one or two projects that we're actually looking at this particular moment in time. Members will be aware of some of the comments that were made when foundations was created in terms of the things that it was being asked to do. We have got a good pipeline of projects that we are working on in this particular moment in time. So in addition to the project in the Dingle and the projects over a new tree ward, you'll have seen press releases in recent weeks about a project in the Faulkner Square conservation area. You'll have seen press releases about the work in Kirkdale, the canal side project consulting local residents on. And there are also a number of other projects that Frank and I discussed with the Regeneration Committee last year that we are still actively pursuing with a view to bringing forward in the not too distant future, all in the way as described within the earlier part of the presentation. So thanks very much for listening to us, and hopefully we can come back in the not too distant future and tell you about some of the projects that we're delivering. Thank you.
Thank you,
Frank
and Mark.
And
members, if you're here to take questions.
So there's a few suggestions that I've not should probably be careful.